10 years AD. I went for a picnic with Joseph and Mary and the young Jesse. Nobody brought any Rizla papers, nobody brought a pipe. And after 14 fucking miles on a donkey, Mary wanted a smoke bad. Little Jesus, he pointed up to the sky and he said, "Hey mum, look, it's a message from Dad." There was a choir of angels singing in the sky, advising Jesus and Mary and Joseph on a new way to get high. He pointed down to the camping stove below. Joseph got the knives out of his cap into his tool bag. Mary smashed the bottom off a milk bottle. Jesus shot the resin into tiny pieces. I looked on in amazement as the donkey pressed play on the ghetto blaster and Grandmaster Flash kicked in. And above us, in the Palestinian sky, the angels sang. So I sat alone and did some hot knives with Jesus and Mary and Joseph and even the donkey. Got fucked up in space on squidgy black. I'm so glad there's a war in Afghanistan because the soldiers are bringing the squidgy black back. I like a good war, me, I like to see the drugs flow. And me and Jesus, we sat down and we put on the stereo. And we were listening to Axis Bonus Love by Jimi Hendrix. And then Joseph started moaning about the fucking noise. And then Joseph started getting fucking paranoid again. And he says to Mary, "Hey, Mary, how the fuck did you get pregnant?" "I was on War 4 in Linfield Mall when you got pregnant, love. I was on enough flag axel, I couldn't even get a fucking hard on. How come you got fucking pregnant? And how come me and you, Mary, look fucking Palestinian? But our Jesus looks fucking Norwegian? How come our Jesus, he's 6'4", blonde hair, blue eyes and a beard? Why the fuck has he got a beard? He's only 7. And Mary just looked at Joseph in disgust and she said, "Chill out, Robin. Chill out, Robin. Everybody now. Chill out, Robin. Chill out, Robin." And Mary explained to Joseph that having a kid was not a bad thing. How the fuck did they think they got that council flat in Galilee? How the fuck did they think they got that fucking child benefit money for? Eh? You paranoid fucking knobhead Joseph. But Jesus, we're having none of this. He says to Joseph, "My other dad is God. And you're not my real dad." So Joseph insisted on all of them going on Jeremy Kyle. Jeremy Kyle did a DNA test on Jesus and it did turn out that Joseph was not the father. Joseph was well upset, but Jesus was proper buzzing. Because he could make MDMA out of Chris. He could do miracles like you couldn't believe. He could make white people dance. He could make policemen smile. He could make Ilkley fall down a big fucking hole.
Forward!
He could do some right shit with Jesus. He could walk round fucking mothers with Jesus. And when you got home, Jesus just opened up his green bomber jacket. And he had fucking packets and packets of bacon that he never paid for. He was the Son of God. He truly was. And he could fix computers like nothing else. He changed all the decimal points on my gyro. Nice one, Jesus. 67,020 million pounds a week for me. And there was a choir of angels singing in the sky. They were pleased and happy that me and Jesus were getting high. The angels looked down and they smiled, and one of the angels dropped down with a copy of Ian Jury's Reasons to be Cheerful.
Part three.
Put it on the stereo. And I thought to myself, you know what? I met Ian Jury when I was 14 in Bradford. He was in a play.
Yes.
And they took us from school to see the play. And I got to meet Ian Jury, and I never realised he had polio or anything like that. I just thought he was a pop star. And he said to me and my mates, what do you want to do when you leave school? And I said, I want to be a punk singer. But then I didn't do anything about it till 34. But it didn't matter, because neither did Ian Jury. And he was fucking brilliant. And above us, in the Palestinian sky, the angels sang.
What must I do for you?
Later, Jesus and myself were living just past St. Luke's in Little Orton. We had a smashing house and we had all these mates called the Apostles. They were lovely lads. Well, when I say lovely lads, they were thieving bastards, but they were lovely lads. And we used to sit around playing Jenga and having a nice time. And then there was this one apostle, and no one was too sure about him. He looked suspiciously like Gordon Ramsay, the celebrity TV chef. He came from Battersea. He was a Chelsea fan. He was a bit light-fingered. No one really trusted him. His name was Judas. And one night Judas said, does anybody need help from the all-night garage, bruv? And everyone said, no, you're all right, mate. And Jesus said, I don't need anything, mate. I'm the son of God, you fucking twat. I can turn Blackpool into Las Vegas. I can turn Tristan Ackroyd into Charlotte Church, topless on a skateboard, going down Cavendish Street. I'm Jesus, mate. I don't need anything from the all-night garage. And Judas says to me, do you need anything from the all-night garage? He says, yeah. Could you get us some king-size blues? And some other king-size blues. And he went off. And we were chilling. And we started listening to Sham 69.
Aye.
And we were having a good night, and then there was a knock on the door. I thought, who the fuck's that? And it was Judas. He came back, but he didn't come alone. He came back, but he didn't come on his own. He brought the drug squad with him. They charged with possession with intent to enjoy. He brought those in benefit with him. They charged with doing miracles on sidewalk, claiming incapacity of benefits. You fucking twat, Judas! And me and Jesus were sentenced to be crucified outside Bradford Interchange. All the taxi drivers were taking the piss out of us. We were nailed up on some wood. It wasn't very good. And I said to Jesus, it's alright for you, you vegan Norwegian bastard. You'll be back on fucking Monday saying, where's my fucking Easter egg? What about me? I says to Jesus, what about me? And Jesus looked at me and he said, chill out, Nobby. Chill out, Nobby. Chill out, Nobby. Chill out, Nobby. He says, I've had a word with me dad. And a choir of angels appeared up in front of us. And one of the angels looked like she might be about to suck me off. And I thought, a blowjob from an angel. But then the angel said, no, I'm sorry, love. I've heard that you don't really wash. And I'm not a big cheese lover. I'm an angel. But she did redeem the situation by producing an A4 sheet of double dipped strawberry LSD. Yay! And she folded it up, the whole fucking sheet, and popped it into my mouth. And she said, "Don't worry about dying, dickhead. Dying's the least of your worries now. You won't even know whether you're dead. You're gonna be tripping that hard, you're gonna think you're a fucking mongoose." In the distance I could hear a Toyota Corolla with a sound system turned up, and the Palestinian angels were just about to sing, and then the Israeli angels tried to build a wall around them, but the Palestinian angels built a tunnel under the wall. Fuck you, Israeli angels. And the Palestinian angels sang, "Good boy."